Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about the salts of oxoacids of the group 1. First let us define what is an oxoacid. Oxoacids are the acids in which the acidic proton is on a hydroxyl group with an oxo group attached to the same atom. Examples of oxoacids are carbonic acid, sulfuric acid, nitric acid. Let us see why these acids are called as oxoacid. Better we can make the structure for these so that the definition will be clear why these acids are called as oxoacids. In this, the central atom is sulfur that we need to write in the center, and here because H2SO4 there are two protons, that is H2 protons. These protons are with the hydroxyl group. This is called as a hydroxyl group. There are two hydroxyl group and the acidic proton, that means the proton which is can be donated by the acid, that is called as acidic proton, and that proton is with the hydroxyl group. You can see the hydroxyl group here. Two hydroxyl groups are there. So the acidic proton is with the hydroxyl group. So here two acidic protons are there, and both acidic protons are with hydroxyl group, and this hydroxyl group is attached to the same atom on which the oxo group is also there. Which one is called as oxo group? That is a double bonded O group is called as oxo group. So the definition for the oxo acid is the acid in which acidic proton, that is the H, is with the hydroxyl group, that you can see the H is with hydroxyl group, and which is attached to the same atom on which oxo group is also there. Oxo group, that is a double bonded O group, is called as oxo group. So here two acidic protons are there. Both the acidic proton are with the hydroxyl group, that is OH group, which is attached with the same element from which the oxo group is also attached. Because here the two oxo groups, this and two hydroxyl group, all these are attached to the same central atom, that is sulfur. So this is the definition for the oxoacid. Let us take some other example also, that is nitric acid and carbonic acid. In nitric acid, the central atom is nitrogen. Here only one acidic proton is there because HNO3, here only one hydrogen is there, that means one acidic proton. That acidic proton is with the hydroxyl group, and that is attached to the nitrogen, and two oxo groups are there which is attached to the nitrogen. So the definition of oxo acid, we have defined it having the acidic proton with the hydroxyl group, which is attached to the same element on which the oxo group is also attached. In the case of carbonic acid, here two hydrogens are there, that means two acidic protons are there, which is with the hydroxyl group, and which is attached to the central atom carbon, on which the oxo group is also attached, that you can see only one oxo group is there. So this is what are called as oxoacids. So as we have defined, the oxoacids are the acids which having the acidic proton on a hydroxyl group with an oxo group attached to the same atom. So this is the definition for oxoacid, and these are the common examples for oxoacid. Now my question is, we are familiar with the acid HCl, hydrochloric acid. Can we call it as an oxoacid? No, we can't call it as an oxoacid because there is no hydroxyl group and even there is no oxo group. So it is not an example of a oxo acid, that is a mineral acid. All the alkali metals form the all oxo acids. The alkali metals forms the salts with the all oxo acids. It can form easily salts with the oxo acid. They are soluble in the water. These salts are soluble in water. Their carbonates are mainly hydrogen carbonate. So these are the some important points related to oxo acids, their salts. So let us take one examples of a salt of oxo acid, that is Na2SO4 is a salt of sulfuric acid. That is Na is the alkali metal. It forms the salt with the sulfuric acid, that is an oxo acid. That salt is sodium sulfate, Na2SO4. This salt in the water, it ionizes to form sodium ion and sulfate ion. So the alkali metals are highly electropositive. Therefore, their hydroxides are very strong bases. Hence, they form salts with all oxo acids like carbonic acid, phosphoric acid, sulfuric acid, nitrous acid, etc. So, because of this reason, the alkali metals of being highly electropositive, they forms hydroxide like sodium. Sodium is an alkali metal. It can form hydroxide NaOH, and this NaOH, when it combines with the, when it react with the oxo acid like sulfuric acid, it form the salt. As we know that base plus acid neutralization takes place, and it result in the formation of salt. So here it result in the formation of salt, that is Na2SO4. So why it forms the salts of oxo acid? Because of highly electropositive nature of alkali metals. So that's why it can form a strong base, that is NaOH is a strong base, which when it react with an oxo acid like sulfuric acid, it forms a salt. That is Na2SO4 is a salt of oxo acid. So that is what we have learnt in this video. That is, the alkali metals forms the salts of oxo acids because of the highly electropositive nature. So it is also an important concept. So this is all about this video. Have a nice day.